What's going on, YouTube? Raphael back with another Spider-Man Classic review for my Spider-Man week. And today we're going to look at a pretty cool figure. Today we're going to be looking at the Spider-Man Classics Scarlet Spider. Now this is kind of a rare figure. It does come pretty pricey also. And I picked this figure up loose for a really good price. And I really think the figure is cool. You know what I mean? It's you know, I guess it's different, but I mean, I would not spend, like, I don't know, the prices are like 70, 80, maybe more on this damn figure, and I really would not spend it on this figure. It's just the color's kind of plain. But I mean, I love the Scarlet Spider. I'm a big fan of the character. But just this figure, I mean, I don't think it's worth that much money. But either way, let's get into the figure. I mean, it is a decent figure though. He comes with this little cloth, little sweater here, which is pretty cool. It's a hoodie, so it does, you know, it can go over his head, seen there. So that's pretty cool. The color of the Scarlet Spider, it's just pretty plain. Nothing really, like, too special about the paint application on the figure. He's got his little spider logo on his little sweater there. Man, that's pretty much it. There's not really much to say about this figure. I mean, he's a cool figure. He's a cool figure to have for your collection. Articulation-wise, the legs go in and out. Does bend at the knee. He does have a toe articulation, a foot swivel. His upper leg can rotate 360. His arms go in and out. He bends at the elbow. He has his two-finger articulation. Like if he's shooting out his web, just like, you know, all the other Spider-Man classics kind of have. He's got a wrist articulation. His head can go up and down, 360. He does have a little upper torso crunch. His waist can rotate 360. And like I said, when this figure's plain, he's just a plain figure. There's not really much to him. If you were to lift up his sweater, there's nothing there. It's just a plain figure. I think they could have added more detail to him, maybe a better paint application. I mean, I'm not trying to complain about the figure. Like I said, I like the figure. I love the character, but it just kind of sucks that, you know, the figure is so pricey, and it's not really that great of a figure. You know, to where we can say it's like worth like $80 or $90. You know, but it's a cool figure. If you can find him cheap, I totally recommend you get him. I like the Spider-Man 2099 better than I like this one. I mean, the character-wise, I like this character better, but the figure-wise, I like the Spider-Man 2099 better. But like I said, he's a cool figure. So we'll get a close-up on this guy. Not much to him. He's just kind of plain. I've seen a few customs on YouTube that would look really nice. But like I said, if you're a Spider-Man collector like me, you're gonna end up picking this guy up. So that's pretty much it. Little quick review on this guy, Spider-Man Classics Scarlet Spider. Decent figure. I picked him up loose, like I said, so he didn't really come with... I don't have any accessories or the comic he came with. Alright guys, thanks for checking out my video, and don't forget to rate my videos and subscribe if you haven't subscribed. See you guys later.